If you've been following AI advancements in the open source space, you've likely heard of Hugging Face, the company named after a cute emoji. Hugging Face is a French-American company focused on open source machine learning tools, especially for natural language processing. Their core offerings include Transformers Library, a collection of pre-trained models for tasks like text classification, translation, summarization, and more. Datasets Library, a repository of ready-to-use datasets for training and evaluating ML models. And Hugging Face Hub, a central platform to share and explore models, datasets, and ML applications. The hub is like the GitHub of AI, where you can collaborate with other machine learning enthusiasts and experts and learn from their work and experience. There are some terms you'll need to know to get the most out of working with Hugging Face. Pre-trained model. A pre-trained model is a machine learning model that has already been taught using a large amount of data to do a specific task, like recognizing images or understanding language, so you can use it right away without starting from scratch. Inference. Inference is the process of using a trained model to make predictions or draw conclusions about new, unseen data based on the learned patterns from the training data. The machine learning process can be divided into two key phases. Training. This is where the machine learns by being shown lots of examples. For instance, if you're teaching it to recognize cars, you give it many labeled pictures of different cars. The machine studies these examples and builds its understanding. Inference. Now that the machine has learned, it uses that knowledge to recognize new things. So, when you show it a picture of a car it hasn't seen before, it can still tell that it's a car based on what it learned during training. Transformers. Transformers are models that can handle text-based tasks, such as translation, summarization, and text generation. They use a special architecture that relies on attention mechanisms to capture the relationships between words and sentences. A tokenizer is a process that breaks down text into smaller units called tokens. Tokens are usually words or subwords that can be used for natural language processing tasks. I hope this overview of key terminologies will help you navigate Hugging Face with greater ease and confidence. To get started with Hugging Face, you will need to set up an account and install the necessary libraries and dependencies. We'll go through this process step by step. Signing up as a community individual contributor is free of charge. You can also opt for a pro plan or a customized plan for organizations if you need more features and resources. Go to the Hugging Face website and click on Sign Up to create a free account. You may be asked to complete a quick verification to confirm you're human. Just follow the on-screen instructions. Then enter your email address and a password. Click Next and complete your profile. Next, generate your avatar and click Create Account once more. You'll need to click the Hugging Face link sent to your email to verify the address used for your account. Congratulations, you are now a Hugging Face member. Before you start using the Hugging Face Hub programmatically, you will need to set up your environment. Step 1. Install Python and pip. Make sure you have Python 3.8 or higher installed on your system. If you don't have Python, you can install it by forming the official Python site. You will also need pip, the package manager for Python, to install the Hugging Face libraries. You don't need to install it separately. It's already included with Python. Next, we'll install the necessary Hugging Face libraries. But before doing that, I'll create a virtual environment. Using a virtual environment helps keep your project dependencies isolated from your system-wide packages, making your setup cleaner and easier to manage. Two common options to create a virtual environment in Python are through venv and conda. Venv is included with Python 3.3 and above. The second option to create a virtual environment is conda that is installed via Anaconda or Miniconda. It is a popular library used for data science and ML projects. I'll be using conda for this project, and it's already installed on my machine. For development, you can use any code editor or IDE you prefer, like Jupyter Notebook, PyCharm, or Visual Studio Code. Start by creating a new project directory and setting up a virtual environment. I have named my environment as Hugging Face. Once the environment is created, activate it using conda activate command. Next, we'll install Hugging Face libraries. Hugging Face has two main libraries that provide access to pre-trained models, transformers and diffusers. The Transformers library handles text-based tasks such as translation, summarization, and text generation. Diffusers can handle image-based tasks such as image synthesis, image editing, and image captioning. Now run this command: pip install transformers. This will install the Hugging Face Transformers library. Now let's see how we can use it to work with pre-trained models. Create a Python file and write this command from Transformers import pipeline. This line imports the pipeline function from the Hugging Face Transformers library. Pipeline is a high-level helper function that makes it very easy to use pre-trained models for common tasks. It handles the tasks like loading the appropriate model, tokenizing the input, running the model, and formatting the output, all with just a few lines of code. But this command requires a model backend, PyTorch or TensorFlow, to actually load the model. We'll install TensorFlow. Run the command: pip install TensorFlow. Once installed, you are ready to use the Transformer library. Next, we'll load the pre-trained sentiment analysis model using the pipeline command. The function pipeline with parameter sentiment analysis sets up everything we need to analyze whether a piece of text is positive or negative. We're also specifying the exact model we want to use. DistilBERT base uncased fine-tuned SST to English. DistilBERT is a smaller and faster version of the popular BERT model, perfect for quick tasks. Base uncased means it uses lowercase text and ignores capitalization. And fine-tuned on SST2 means it's been trained specifically for sentiment classification using a dataset called SST2. So when we write sentiment analysis equals pipeline, we're setting up a ready-to-use tool that can take any sentence and tell us if the sentiment is positive or negative with just one line of code. Next, create a variable called input_text to store the text you want the model to analyze. Now we'll call the pipeline with our input text and save the output to a variable. Next, we'll use a print command to print the result on the terminal. Before running the code, make sure the correct Conda environment is active. Press Shift, Command, and P together to open the command palette in VS Code and select the appropriate Python interpreter. Now, run the code by executing Python followed by the file name in the terminal. After executing the command, a Python dependency conflict appeared. I resolved this issue by installing the recommended version of Keras. Next, I ran the Python file again. This time, the code executed successfully and the model returned the sentiment analysis. In this case, it identified the text as negative with a confidence of 99.96%. I ran the code again, this time with a positive sentence. The model confidently identified the sentiment as positive. You can see how easy it is to get a pre-trained model up and running using Hugging Face's libraries. But how can you find the right pre-trained model if you want to perform a specific task? This is actually quite easy. You can browse the models on the Hugging Face website and filter them by task, libraries, languages, and more. You can also search for models and datasets by keyword and sort them by trending, most likes, most downloads, or by recent updates. Each model has a model card that contains important information, such as model details, usage example, link to the files, and community interaction features. You can also check the list of spaces that are using that particular model and further explore the spaces by clicking on the space link. If you'd like, you can even clone a space to your local machine and run it yourself. That's it. You're now equipped with the essential tools to start integrating Hugging Face models into your own AI applications.